Yes, hi, hello. It's been a while. It hasn't. Oh shit, I'm loud as fuck. I'm Swizzy Skies, and it is San Anto Saturdays, and I'm here with
Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect himself. So, can you tell me a little bit about how you came up with that name?
Actually, the name was given to me by my old high school football coach. Yes, because we was on the team, we was like top 10 in the nation, all this good stuff. I was a highly recruited high school football player. So, and our work ethic as far as the team wise and the group, our group that we were with and my teammates. So the coach one day was like, "You always trying to do something to get it perfect." So I was like, I mean, it's perfect. I got to get it perfect. If I don't get it right, then it won't be done right. It's not perfect. It's not right. Since that day, even on Facebook, since then, I've always been my name, Mr. Perfect. So it's been that forever.
So when did you start making music?
I started soon after I got out of the military in 2015. I've actually started engineering and writing and making my own music as well. When I was in college, I went back to Shepherd University in West Virginia. One of my old buddies that I played football with, he was like, "Go in there and make a song." I was like, "What? I never ever tried to do this." I was a good writer, all that stuff. Because I was written. But, so I did the song, and I was like, "Ooh, I like this." And then I ended up making another song. And then we did like 4 songs just that day. It was fun. It wasn't that great at the same time, but it was the beginning.
Yeah,
and then since then, I started learning engineering. I did a lot of work with a lot of artists in the DC area.
Oh,
because
you're not from here.
Originally from Atlanta. That's where my roots are. And then I moved to Maryland, DC area. Mm-hmm. And then that's where I went to high school and stuff. And I just recently moved out here about 2 years ago. Then I went back and then I came back out just a year ago. Mm-hmm. And that's when I really started progressing my music in the area. So.
Have you worked with any local artists this year?
Local artists? I've worked with artists like Apollo, worked with Waylon, Big Bone, that guy. I've worked with the Sleeper Parks. Yeah.
Dude, I gotta check him out.
Speaker Parsons, who else did I work with? I've been produced by Cabal, who's a local artist and mixer. Haven't actually worked with, but I got a great relationship with Concept and those guys, Apollo Black, all those guys, that's goodness of people. The only fits with DJ Roxy, she's so good. Worked with Stoplight Studios. The list goes on.
Yeah. What do you want to work with?
Honestly, the artist I really want to work with would be Benny Butcher or anybody in that Griselda camp.
Yeah.
Because
that's fair.
That's my niche. Besides me making my actual music, that's the melodic side of me. Me on my grimy side, I go like that. Yeah. When I do my little freestyles and stuff,
So you freestyle?
Not really. Not live. I'm in a studio kind of guy.
Okay, in a studio.
I hear the comments. That's why I gotta go listen.
Go check him out.
Exactly.
That's funny. You said you were in the military. I remember you saying that, right? Tell me us how you went from
college athlete to military.
I'm just curious.
Let's just say I had to get away.
Okay, yeah.
And then I ended up going to the military, better day, better life. I started. new family at that time. My son was, I had a son. So I just wanted to secure his future more type of thing.
Yeah.
I went to the military. I was in the military 4.5 years. I went to Afghanistan. I did a, I was on a Navy ship as well. Then I got out. And since then, it's went back to school for business and then I've been focused on music and just making more money kind of part of the thing.
Yeah. It's always really cool to me to see everyone's like journey to where we want to be.
Yeah. I know we've been everywhere in the world. I can tell you that. My favorite place is Singapore. I love that place.
Singapore.
Amazing place. If anyone that ever has a chance to go, take it out.
Can you describe your music style?
If you put Jay Z on your 3000, himself, a little bit of Lil Wayne, a little bit of Wale, J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, in my original beat, that's what describe myself. Put it all in the thought. That's what meant to me. Because those are the artists that were like inspired by music at the same time. And of course I rap about me and my struggles and what I've seen over my years and my days. And people may take what they want from it, but I'm just saying it in a perspective that I put it in words type of thing. But it has so many meanings beyond what people hear at the same time.
That's fair. It doesn't always mean like one thing, it's just like...
Right, like our previous conversation. Different people take what they want out of it, but not all ears hear the same thing.
Not all ears hear the same thing. That's true. So tell me a little bit about your inspirations. What keeps you going? Or who, not what keeps you going, but like, who was it that sparked that fire?
Mm-hmm. First off, my son. And then family, of course, my mother. She just got over breast cancer. Mm-hmm. Shout out to that.
Yeah.
Shout out to that for real. Also my homeboy, Dave. He's a fighter now. He actually stays out in Austin. What else? That's pretty much it there. I'm like a short-knit kind of, I don't have too many friends.
Yeah.
I've always been closed off and isolated. But I still get out and have fun. I'm a Gemini, so I got that different kind of energy. Like I'm that, but see me in another light, I'm like everywhere.
Yeah.
And still know a lot of people at the same time. It's just, not everybody's within my circle, but I'm still friendly, genuine, of course, with everyone.
Yeah. Genius. Okay, so tell me about your favorite food. Yeah.
Well, lately I've been trying this vegan thing.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah. And I like these actual substitutes, don't get me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
There ain't nothing like some red meat. You know, I don't know pork, and I ran into beef, but my favorite, I say, is shrimp pasta, potato shrimp pasta, so that's one of the top five. Shrimp and grits,
mm-hmm.
I'm a country guy, so.
Hell yeah.
That's good old country meals. I don't even have chicken parmesan. A good spaghetti.
A good spaghetti, yeah.
I mean, for real.
That's fair. Okay, well, are you gonna keep going?
That's my regular dish. I get to desserts.
Okay.
It's fine.
Okay, 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 desserts.
Chocolate. Ice cream, you got it, and chocolate chip cookies and bread. I live off those. I could not eat anything, but if I got some chocolate ice cream and a brownie, I'm good. Living life, it's a chocolate milk.
It's for chocolate milk, everything chocolate.
What is a natural yeast name? So that's kind of all right.
What?
You gotta drink water.
Oh, that's funny. So how would you describe 2022 as an appetizer?
As an appetizer? It's like a variety of drink.
A variety?
A platter of platter. It's a little bit of chicken nuggets and veggies and egg roll. Don't know what you get every day. Maybe something new. Somebody dying, or like different. Like something just popping up every day. A variety, different shit. I'm that person.
Oh, damn. No, the variety. So yeah, it's 2022. So, what do you struggle with most, and how do you handle that? I mean, like, this year obviously has been crazy for variety. I mean, was there something in there that, like, you had to just, like, do something different about, or?
Yeah.
You don't have to. I'm sorry.
That's more of my struggles this year, more like personal stuff type of thing. But I'm not gonna get into that right there. But other than that, like I said, this year for me has been more like my anxiety of late has really been kicking in. So I've been like, pretty much the whole summer, it's like I took off, checked out completely. And I'm just now getting back outside, getting back doing shows and events. Like I got a show tonight. That show, I'm headlining at the end of the month. Jay Scott comedy show that he does every third Friday. Friday after Thanksgiving. Another one for concert in December, one of their shows. Pay Dues Festival. So I'm back outside.
I'm back. Well, that's good. I'm glad you're able to overcome anxiety. It's something I definitely struggle with a lot.
Yeah.
For sure. And it definitely keeps me isolated. But that's why I try and do little things like this, you know?
Yeah, get you outside the box, get you like social information.
Yeah,
like,
a little bit.
Things that challenge you.
Yes, for sure. I'll just be in here. Like, there's no need.
Try not to overthink it. Just live your life. That's all. Try to do.
Work in progress.
Fight through the adversity. That's all.
Tell me an unpopular opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me an unpopular opinion.
Kanye.
What?
Kanye.
What about him? You like him?
Don't get me wrong. He has a lot of unpopular statements and views amongst society.
Yeah, for sure.
But you can't take away from what he's done as a brilliant man in general. From the beginning of time, when no one knew who his name was, making Rockefeller, making Jay-Z's name, who is hip hop now, and how he integrated. Worked so hard just to build his own name when no one wanted him there. Throughout his whole career, he's been fighting through when no one wants him there. So I see greatness through that person in that story, even though don't be unpopular beliefs.
No, I like Kanye. Sure.
That would make it crazy. Just like another crazy Gemini. I understand it because I'm a fellow brother.
What would you say your most slept on song is?
first song on my first album, my intro melody, just simply based on my part. I think it's only like 8 bars besides like the hook and just me ending up the poem on the back end that higher level.
Melody. What's your favorite song that you ever wrote?
Favorite song I've ever wrote.
Whether it's
do you know how many songs I've written?
You don't have a favorite? I feel like I would have a favorite.
Yes,
right
I
now.
Have a, I have a list. But maybe me.
He's like, yeah, he's kind of.
I would say it's one of my recent singles, Destiny. It's because that, the whole musical experience, I came up with the original melody for the beat, and then my producer, which was back in DC, he created the beat for me, and we were just playing off each other. I was telling him the sounds, and I would play some tunes, he would play some stuff, and we developed the beat. So we shared the production credits for that beat. And then, just in the studio, I started singing the hook, and then naturally I just started writing. And then he was like, "Are you ready?" So, I just looked. He saw the look in my eye. I just looked up. I was like, "I'm ready." He's like, "You just wrote it, though." I was like, "It don't matter. It don't matter. I know this one." And then just, it was magic for real. And the song is so impactful because I'm talking about just through life, like what's your destiny? I got the recipe. I smoked a blunt and runs. I took off now, I'm feeling stuck. I'm in the run, I get a bunch. I smoke until the road is gone. Everybody call my phone, so I guess it's on me. So I'm not telling the whole story of my life and how pressure's building up, and either you're dying or you let the pressure go. Burst. So I give that story throughout. And it's very inspirational, I think.
Yeah.
So it's probably one of my most positive songs and great songs.
Yeah.
Overall.
Yeah. That's well.
I've seen you got a little quick freestyle.
I know, see that. So you can.
Charge for that.
Charge them. Who's your biggest supporter?
Biggest supporter is myself. My biggest supporter is my mother, my dad, my little brother in here. My girl at this point. It's amazing. And from there, it's like it's other artists actually. Like Wayne, he supports me, I support him. We've been partners, we've done shows in the area, done fire groups, and Stop Playing Studios. They're amazing. They've been a big help since I've been out here as well, supporting the shows we used to throw out with them and stuff like that as well. Myself is my biggest support. Because I go out a lot for me. And no one else will.
Yeah. Not yet.
No.
That's good. If you could be anywhere right now, where would you be?
Jeez.
Whether that's in life or whether that's a location.
In life, obviously, I don't want to be another tax bracket, first off. location, though. If I could bring the three locations together, That will be my location. Between all my homes, between Atlanta, DC, and here. Bring those together, that would be my location.
Never thought about it like that. That would be cool. I like that with you. But you do anything else besides make music? Like, do you have a weird hobby or not weird art, but you know, you collect rocks or snakes?
I have my stones and so I'm a highly spiritual dude, so I got my meditation bowls and my chakra beads. Yeah, that stuff. But my hobby, I'm actually not that cool. I'm pretty boring. I'm a pet guy. I just got a puppy. It's 10 weeks. Shout out to Concept for doing some experimental breeding. Love it. She's so cute. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but yeah, we got three dogs. Yeah, a cat. So I'm a pet guy. And other than that, I'm a homebody for real. I get out and do some stuff here and there, but pretty boring.
One day I'm gonna meet a juggler and they're just gonna tell me like that's their hobby.
Oh, I can juggle.
Can you juggle?
Yes.
No, but like that's not your hobby. No, like
I was just doing it for myself. Like, just for real? Yes.
That's funny. I
juggle those things.
Then that was today.
I learned that in college in kinesiology, motor learning skills. And that's how I learned.
Yeah. Not coordinated. I don't know, so I can never do sports. I mean, you played football. Did you play any other sports?
My high school consisted of indoor track, well, football season, indoor track, outdoor track, and I played basketball too. Wow. So I did it all.
Yeah. Would you say football's your favorite?
Football definitely my favorite, obviously. But I'm better at basketball. Overlooked basketball. Overlooked.
That's funny. Who's your favorite team?
I'm an Atlanta Falcons fan. This I like the newly Commanders, Washington football, whatever you call. Because I grew up in D.C. Basketball. I'm a big LeBron fan and James Harden fan. No real team, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I just like the sport, but never really had a team. Now that I'm thinking about it, I never had a team for basketball. I was there because I always had players in them, so.
Yeah.
That. Irritating. Interesting. Reliving childhood trauma.
Oh no.
It's okay.
That's fine. You know.
Almost had a moment there.
Yeah. You triggered mine.
Save myself.
Oh man. What do you want to be when you were little? Like, what do you want to be when you grow up?
I wanted to be a marine biologist. That was my original life goal.
Why?
I don't know. I like the water. I like animals. I like going to an aquarium. So that experience, I was like, I won't be here. That's a little known fact about me, though.
Why?
It was that where I actually made it to the NFL. Which I had my opportunity, but I tore my ACL. Yeah, I still played, but it didn't quite heal the way I wanted it to, so I decided to play football.
I'm
sorry. Life is life. We have our past. That's definitely understand it. Sent me through like some tough times during that period, but obviously you grew up.
One way to grow. Jeez. That's just, if you could be any animal, what would you want to be? It sounds like you would be a Marine. And you just never, like, yep, that's, if I had a different life or in the next life, I'd come back as.
I don't want to be an eagle overseeing. I don't want to see the world. Yes. Bird's eye view. Like they say, bird's eye view.
Being up in there.
I never really thought about it. I just rationalized it as you were asking the question. That's a good question there.
It's just random. I've always wanted to be a cat. So.
A cat?
Yeah.
Why a cat?
Because I can do whatever they want.
Because you think we are in our lives?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's that fear factor. I'm like scared of everything, so to be
fearless.
Fearless.
What's the most fearless creature?
A cat.
Are you sure?
Yeah, dude, they no, like slug.
Honey badger.
A honey badger?
They don't give a fuck.
I don't want to give a fuck. I don't care. No, I still want to care. But when I want to, you know, like, not fair all
enough
the time.
Fair enough. I understand.
Ooh, what's a commercial jingle that you will never forget?
Commercial
jingle. Like, what is that one that played over and over and over again? Now it's like stuck in your head forever. Let's bring it back.
Fucking Hulk Hogan doing this spring into a slim jim commercial. I used to verse them and just that the Slim Jim, Hulk Hogan, specifically the Hulk Hogan. That, definitely.
Yeah. Oh man. That's funny. Cool. You said you were a Harry Potter fan.
Yes.
What's your, what are they called? See, look, I'm not even going to say what they're called.
Gryffindor?
Is that your?
I'm very wholesome. I like, I'm nice, but I know my power at the same time.
Yeah.
Nice kid, but he knows his power. But sometimes he don't. Very powerful when it is.
That's fair.
Guns.
That's fair. That's absolutely fair. Victorian wear. What would you call
it? Victorian wear. I would go international.
Yeah.
In your country, your Africa areas. Because their support level. So even like American artists, people that just make music, good music, good general artists out there.
Mm-hmm.
It's in that area.
Yeah, those festivals are huge.
Yes.
They're ridiculous. I've always wanted to go to a festival.
I have a homeboy that raps and he's out there in like in France and he does music like that. He does one. It's crazy support when he gets out there.
Yeah.
Especially like, that's why I love my area, because you guys said you gotta leave your area in order to do something. So
that's true.
That's what brought me here. That's where I took a leap of faith and just decided to start over initially.
Yeah. Do you know anyone here?
At this point, yeah. I have like, people I know, very few people I like, just would go hang out with here and there. But I know a lot of people and you know, see people at other shows. We have people at studios.
Yeah.
Yeah. And most of all, my family's here. My baby mother and my son is here. So that's mainly why I'm here. In this area specifically. But this is what it is.
Do you have a bucket list?
even after I got out.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I stay right in the San Diego, LA area. So, yeah. Seeing that scene as well, it's pretty nice stuff.
Yeah.
All the stars and just seeing them, just like LA.
I read a tweet, or was like a thread of some girls saying, yeah, like I've hit this many celebrities thus far with my car, and I was like, it's a thing. Like,
yeah, they just like real life. Paparazzi is real. You see them now, it's a whole different lifestyle and how they spend some money.
Different tax bracket.
Yeah. Luckily, I had benefits then.
Yeah. That's cool. What for the military? That's really cool. What are you working on right now, music wise? Like, what's
I'm putting the finishing touches on the album, getting everyone the cover art and stuff like that, and just putting the final mixes on the song. But I'm gonna put it out probably mid-December. Mid-December. And that's Tales of Gemini, that's what that project's called. I got 3 beats from Grammy Award-winning producer Famous Famous Studios. He has a Grammy for working with Chameleon there actually. That Cabal produced on the album. Future on the album is gonna be Waylon Pickbone, Cat Apollo. Not a problem back, it's another problem out here from the dope artists. But CCG, she's on the track. She's not out in San Antonio anymore, but well, in her time here, she did some nice work for me. What's maybe out? I know I'm missing a person. Someone else is gonna make this album. It'll be a surprise for me. But yes, this project has been like in the works and shuffled around. Projects have been added, dropped, but it's gonna be very beautiful. So I hope people like it though.
You like it?
Oh, I love it.
Okay, that's it. That's it. Oh wow, that's gonna be super, super cool to keep up. For sure. You said you got a cash show for that, right?
Yes.
Today.
Once today, that's just in the future, and we will show up at exactly the right place.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
What did you do?
I woke up this morning.
Mm-hmm.
And then I took a nap.
And then you took a nap?
And then I took a nap. So, no, I actually What about this morning playback for the before the dogs get off?
Oh yeah.
To my days. I did actually go back to sleep. I watched The Office and Animaniacs. Yes. I reflected on how that show made us want to take over the world. And just, it changed our minds to know that we were just this good in the world, you know? It's a good life, and it's fun. For real.
Take over the world? Tell me
about
like,
obviously
like very spiritual, you got like your meditation,
but
it's like, what does that look like for you?
I don't know, it's just the way for me to, like, I guess that's the way I deal with my depression, anxiety, and stuff like that. Just find peace and find balance. And so that's mainly my main key with it, as far as the spirituality.
I know you said that your favorite piece is Singapore. Why?
The people there, it's the most Americanized Asian country in the United States. So they speak their main language is English, even though they have their own language there as well. The people there are nice. You can, the rules are kind of strict, though. If you spin on their ground, you're going to jail, you can. Obviously, so, yeah. 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 2012-ish. Sometimes it's like if I go to visit family, if you're a family again or something like that. Yeah, I really don't have my sight to be set in something. I feel like that event's coming over here and there. As long as I'm around my whole family base and whatever I have to type of stuff. You can have enjoy money. That's me. Trying to take over the world. I guess my next project is going to do around my birthday time in June. So that, which I've already started, is when trying to do more of like for the in the community, try to tap in with just doing some community service stuff like that. That's my next goal.
Is it all planned or just
kind of,
do they just...
The ideas are already there, like, what I want to get there, but not fully at the same time. So I don't know, an artist just to like freelance, or not necessarily freehanded, but like a freestyle thing based off the, give them the main pieces and then from there you fill it in however they draw it up. I'll give them ideas. simply. Simply complicated.
Simply complicated. I mean, no, it makes sense, you know. Makes sense. You want something done a certain way, but if you're fighting someone else, I guess I'm
gonna have. Yeah. You don't have to do that. Yeah, that's how I'm gonna go. That's how I'm gonna work, really.
Yeah. That's cool. Do you draw anything?
I try. I'm not that great of an artist. I didn't get my abilities in that form. I got it more on the vocal side and freaking being able to be a good writer.
Right.
Yeah, that was because of my dad. He was an English major and a teacher. So, yeah, we used to write reading and writing in the house. And that's all I ever did. So, even outside of school, we used to make me do papers. The dark jokes.
Yeah, the dark jokes for sure. Oh, that's funny. I thought about writing a movie. I thought about making music for movies, though. Mm. That's what I'm going to school for.
That's the only reason I had that idea because I actually did an album, but I want to literally make it into the movie as like a music video. So I'm not really even like touch those things until I'm able to do that. Because those particular songs are not doing. And I hate the fact that Katy Perry did it with influence thing on Netflix, and I love that movie. Actually, that shit is fucking amazing. But yeah, I want to do something like that. I had my thoughts. It's about turning it into fruition at this point, making things actually happen. We're taking the steps towards doing that. And I pray that 2023 will be a great year.
What's your creative or writing process like?
Usually, honestly, I just randomly write some lyrics. Half the time, I don't know what song or what idea it is. Either I hear a particular beat or wherever I get my beat from, and then I like go through my list. And I'll be like, you could go from here. And then I literally try different versions and different, because I'm already prepared because I have stuff already written for like ages and that.
Mm.
Yeah.
And so
you have
different versions.
Type of thing, man. Or if the idea is organic, sometimes I'm writing the first video or the studio or something like that. It just depends on the moment, honestly, what type of vibe I'm feeling. If I'm working with other artists, how I'm feeling, what the energy is in the room. It's very good with energy. If I feel like the energy is good and we rock and we roll with it, then I'm going to just be more easygoing and get it out. And I'll probably be the first one to do it first. I got a hook for you, just facilitate it basically or something like that. I done had my moments when I'm in the studio like a freaking Diddy, standing over a freaking producer, like not doing my thing, but like literally like I get like that sometimes, but otherwise I'm pretty, I just need to chill and I sit back and do my thing and let it flow and just do my part and peace out. Some people do have different needs, but it's still me.
That's
it. I think that's it anyway.
That was a lot of fun. Like I said, thank you for.
No, thank you for the opportunity. I enjoyed this for real.
This is really cool. I always enjoy San Anto Saturdays more than I do.
Shout out to people. She's the reason I found you.
Yeah. Uh-huh. I love her.
I love her too. She's one of my favorite artists.
Yes.
She ran the works of that. Ran the works of that. Soon something will come and fit, I guess.
Yes, I love her. She's super, super cool.
Exactly. I love her music and her lyrics. More to speak. There's certain topics. Like,
yeah.
Somebody got to talk about it.
That's what I'm saying. The very first time I ever saw her live, I was, in Denver on shows. Yeah.
She was out of
Denver? Yeah, that girl was out in Denver and I got to see her.
Yeah, I know she'd be going everywhere.
Yeah, that was really, really cool. I was just like, oh my god.
That's crazy. Like,
finally someone fucking see. Yeah.
What were you doing in Denver?
To go see Beatty.
Oh, you actually tried what I did to go see. That's tight.
Yeah.
You were a good fan. I've had some of my best shroom trips right here. Literally. Literally, the skies.
Wow.
Going to the universe.
Yes. I'll check for the next one. I never know how to end these, but I guess bye.
Bye. Thanks for rocking. Mr. Perfect, be the perfect you.